I cannot believe it. It took us nearly 2 years.
Yeah, 2 years to finally meet.
And we're meeting here today and we're going to have heart-to-heart chat and I'm so happy.
I'm happy to see you.
I'm happy to see you.
Can I charge my phone?
Of course you can.
Thank you. Oh, look at this technology. There you go.
Okay, I want to go straight into it. Get into the nitty-gritty of things.
Okay.
Just imagine this one with me. They're making a movie about Amna Al Qubaisi, the first Emirati race driver. Who would you cast to play you?
Oh, good question. If my sister isn't too old, I would say my sister. She didn't get old at that point.
What is your go-to movie or food for comfort?
My go-to movie would be watching like old Disney classic movies. Like relive my childhood. And my food would be sushi.
Top 5 Disney movies.
The Fox and the Hound, Mulan, Pocahontas, Cinderella, Brother Bear.
You're OG. I had a little bird that told me this information. I want to know if it's true or not. Before getting into racing, before getting into Formula One Academy, were you a gymnast?
Yes, I was. For 10 years.
No way.
Yeah.
And what sparked your passion into driving cars?
To be honest, I felt like gymnastics was really boring. When my dad brought racing drivers to the house, they would still talk about racing outside of the track. I was like, I want to try this sport. And that's when I was like pushing my dad at 9 years old. I wanted to start racing.
That's amazing.
Yeah, they were really passionate, like talking about it. They were so passionate that I don't have that kind of passion with gymnastics. So I was like, maybe I should try this one out.
It seems like it runs in the family blood.
Yes, yes.
And your sister, right? She races too.
Yeah, yeah, she's racing with me.
But when did you sense that I want to follow his footsteps?
I mean, it was at 9 that I wanted to do what he was doing. He told me that you guys are privileged, you know, that you get to do this at a young age. He said when he was young, you know, he couldn't do it because his parents were very, you know, hard and they were afraid. If I couldn't do it, I would let you do it and let you live my dream. And I was like, oh my God, I feel this with you. At that point, I was like, I want to follow his footsteps and achieve what he's achieved and, you know, try to make him proud.
When you are making him proud and you're making all of us proud.
Thank you.
What was your earliest memory on track?
My earliest memory would be actually when I was 3 years old, I was driving the quads in the desert. So that was my earliest moment in a vehicle, moving vehicle.
That's a boss lady moment. Like that's
Yeah, because they were all boys and I was the only girl. I was like 4 years old. And I wasn't listening to the rules. I was going out of bounds and where the big guys are going up the sand dunes, I was following them.
I'm sure this is where you discovered your party love and passion.
Yeah.
What's the difference between an electric car and a wagoner?
It's like driving a normal car. So I just press the throttle and it reaches high speed at that point.
That's the future, right?
Yeah. I agree. Yeah, it's the future.
Now that we're talking about track and racing, getting off the track to unwind, because I'm sure it takes a toll on your body, your mental health, your physical actually being. What do you do to unwind?
So for me to unwind, I would usually like sleep all day. I mean, I love sleeping. I sleep 13 hours a day, but during race weekends, I have like 7 to 8 hours of sleep.
13 hours a day?
Yeah.
Mashallah. Every mother's dream.
Really? You don't have that?
Tell me one thing that people don't know about you.
One thing people don't know about me is I'm very reserved. I'm very outgoing, but I have this, like, I'm an introvert.
We know that the racing is male-dominant sport.
Mm-hmm.
Did you ever doubt yourself?
I was told, you know, you shouldn't be in the sports. You should go do something girly or feminine, like horse riding or ballet or something.
No, girly, feminine.
Exactly. They're like, no, you shouldn't do this sport. It's not for you because you're not aggressive. You're not fast. And I was like, no, watch me. I will do better. I mean, I'll be better than all of you soon. And even in Europe, I was achieving top five. So I really like pushed myself to that. But I think it's a good motivation when someone tells you, well, you cannot do it. It's like, no, you know, use that as motivation, inspiration to push yourself further. I was really happy because now I have a sister who would come along to the race weekends with me and someone I could be friends with because, like I said, there's no girls. It's just mainly male dominated, so it's all boys. So I had like a girl and a sister who I could relate to and talk to on track. And at the same time, like, we share such a great bond. We became so close. So
best of both women.
Yeah.
So this is a very honest question. Did you reach a moment in your career where you felt, I made it?
I had one moment when I won the championship in karting in the UAE. That I was like, oh, I reached my, you know, my potential, my success. And then I was like, no, now it's Formula 4. I need to win in Formula 4. Then, like, I went to Formula 3 and I claimed top 10. So, you know, when you go top 10, you get points for your racing. So I was like, oh, I was the first female Arab to get points in Formula 3. And then I was like, no, now I need to win Formula 3. And I still didn't have that sense of satisfaction that I've succeeded yet. Every time that moment comes, you set a new goal. I don't feel satisfied yet. It's always something new that comes up and I'm like, I need to make this so I could succeed.
You've been racing for a decade.
Yeah.
11 years. Do you have a piece of advice? Would you have something to say for the younger Amna?
Yeah, I would say don't take every moment for granted. Always remember that you should take each lap like it's your last. Now that I'm old, I always kept in mind is never take each lap an advantage. Race like it's your last.
And I love the fact that you said, like, take each lap as it's your last. So you might as well enjoy them more.
Exactly, yes.
What do you want people to remember you for? To remember Amna Al Qubaisi?
I want people to remember me for being able to change the stereotype, not just in the country or in the region, but also outside of the region. I want people to know that that I helped make it better for Arabic girls to enter a sport. Not even a sport, even any male-dominated sector around the world.
And speaking of, like, inspiration, is there an inspirational quote or an inspirational saying that you live by, or you want to pass it on for the next generation and people out there will look at you today say, I want to be her?
I saw this quote by Jeff Bezos and it like opened my eyes and changed my life when he said, you know, if you're going through hell, keep going, don't stop at hell. And I was like, that's true. It means you need to keep resisting, keep pushing yourself, keep moving forward, not backwards.
And all of us are so proud of you.
Well, thank you.
You represent the Emirati woman, the Khaliji woman, the Arab woman, a woman in general, that you actually can break the barrier and you can do it.
Thank you. I'm trying.
You are. Yeah, you are. You are. If you could pick one song, either to race on track or song of your life, what would it be?
I would say it would be St. John. I heard you got too lit last night. Do you know it?
I have no idea.
Really? You should listen to it. It's like,
I have no idea.
I heard you got too lit last night.
And then I say, I'm doing it in white song.
Yeah.
They sing it all up. They sing it all up. I don't know what.
Patrol it.
Amna,
yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me, and it's so nice.
Thank you for having me in your life.
Of course.
It's been a blessing.
I know.
I love you, and thank you so much for opening your heart, your soul, and telling us all about who Amna is and your journey, and I'm so grateful and thankful for that.
Thank you so much.
So proud of you, and I love you.
I love you.
I love you. You're the best.
Inti Ahmed.